2010 Logbook Chica. Is there a connection between Glamrock Chica and the ruined Chica we see in the logbook? We know that it can't be Withered Chica just due to different parts being present and missing, which could be explained away since Withered Chica, as we see her, could just be a more rundown version than the Logbook Chica. However, the logbook seems to come before FNAF 6, and FNAF 2 was the first game in the timeline, so this version is newer than the Withered Chica, so who could this mysterious Chica version be? Perhaps it was a teaser towards the new Chica and the rest of Security Breach. After all, the Glamrock animatronics may just be rebuilt originals or use some of the same parts, hence the disrepair. The Logbook Chica could have some form of connection to this new Chica, except I don't know exactly what it could be. What do you think? Do you think that Logbook Chica is a version of Glamrock Chica, or do you think it's something else? Be sure you let me know down below. Minute 9, one of many. Are there multiple Chica animatronics? Or I guess just multiple animatronics of the various characters throughout the Pizzaplex? Honestly, it's possible. It would make sense. Like, if this place is supposed to be filled with kids who want to play mini golf with Monty, are they just supposed to wait for the single animatronic to make his rounds? It seems like the more likely or more business savvy scenario would be to have multiple animatronics of the same character positioned at different locations across the Pizzaplex, so the kids don't have to go looking so hard for their favorites. Like if there's a Monty at every other hole or something at mini golf, it's like he's caught up with the family playing on that hole instead of just there not being any Monty. Same with Chica. Would she have multiple versions all over the place just to satisfy the dads who, let's be honest, are only bringing their kids there after their horrible reputation because Glamrock Chica is slim thick? It seems like the wisest decision business-wise, because it would keep the kids coming back, because if the animatronics are hard to find, why would they go? They could just go to normal mini-putt. But we all know that Fazbear Entertainment isn't the most business-savvy company. FNAF AR Springtrap. And 8, dinner time. We all know that Chica loves pizza, but I feel like pizza would be more Freddy's thing since he's the mascot, right? Well, we know that Chica loves food, and perhaps she loves it a little too much. She is, after all, so far the only animatronic that we've seen in the kitchen, which, I mean, might be a little, bad for Scott. I mean, Scott's already stepped down, so what else can he do? But if Chica really does love food, what if she isn't after us at all, but rather is trying to grab us so that she can bring us to the food court? Look, I know it sounds weird, but you have to know that there is a place in Toronto called Chica's Chicken. And I can only talk about it if I bring up Chica wanting food, so pretty much that's why this number is here. That's the only reason. But I still might be onto something. A lot of people are guessing that Chica is going to be a good guy. What if she, like a loving partner, is just trying to make sure that you ate dinner today? It could be a thing! In FNAF VR, instead of jump scaring us in the Pizza Party minigame, we see Chica get distracted by pizza. So maybe she just wants us to get that yum yum in our tum tum. Huh? Did you ever think about that? And yes, this is a scary theory because a place called Chica's Chicken actually exists. That's why it's scary. I have it saved on Google Maps in places I want to go. And it's 7, Harley Quinn. Is Glamrock Chica actually based on or inspired by Harley Quinn from DC Comics? Now, I'm going to go a little bit top 10 nerd on you for a minute, but I saw this comment left on the official Security Breach gameplay trailer, saying that while Vanny does seem Harley-esque, Chica is a much closer match, thanks to the pink on her costume and the murderous intent, even though originally she was trying to be good, in reference to the hardware they installed on the toy animatronics. Plus, Chica is very much looked at in a similar way to Harley, and I hate that I have to say that, where they're both, quote, psycho yet sexy, as some Redditors are putting it, which is just weird. Psycho isn't sexy, okay? It's not a good thing. Nevertheless, could this interpretation be more Harley Quinn inspired? I doubt it, but if she ends up using her guitar like a hammer, I don't know how I'm gonna feel about it at that point because it will basically be confirmed. If the other animatronics would be supervillains, or I guess maybe superheroes, even though I doubt it, who do you think that they would be? I think that Monty would either be Solomon Grundy or Hulk, but like evil, and then like Roxanne would be like Cheetah. I don't know about Glamrock Freddy. He's giving me more Star Wars vibes with like the Tauntaun mechanics. Yeah, if you know, you know. And it's 6, rebuilt toy. Could Glamrock Chica possibly be a rebuilt toy animatronic? It's very possible, considering how the two share the same shape, figure, and silhouette. And to our knowledge, the toy animatronics were scrapped, but also potentially saved for a later date. The only issue that I see with this is that FNAF 2 is the earliest game in the series, so if they scrapped it, that means that they would have to hold on to these animatronics and not reuse them for parts for over 30 years. At this point, more like 40 plus by the time Security Breach rolls around. I don't actually know what year this would have taken place in. Like, how long is the FNAF timeline? I don't know, that's a theory for another day. But even if they did keep the full toy animatronics and then just fix them up with a fresh coat of paint for the Pizzaplex, would that even make sense? Well, from what we've seen in the trailers, it actually could, with the red eyes potentially being left over from when the animatronics could have spotted someone in their database, and their security guard-like movements and actions could be left over from that programming as well. And if now they're evil, it would be pretty easy to reverse that code, and just make them go berserk on anyone who isn't a threat. I don't know. It could be possible, but holding onto these animatronics for 30 years and then not ever reusing their parts before the Pizzaplex doesn't seem likely. Halfway through into number 5, friendly. Is Glamrock Chica friendly? This is a theory that's been brought up multiple times within the extended wait time for Security Breach's release, however I don't think we've talked about it much, if at all. We know from trailers and statues that Freddy in this game is going to be our friend. For the first time in the series, an animatronic will really be trying to help us not die. However, after some posters, and more particularly the Broken Chica teaser for Security Breach, the possibility of Chica helping us is also on the rise. Aside from potentially being a good partner and bringing us to get food, Chica in this teaser, thanks to a Daco stream, actually shows us Glamrock Chica broken, beaten, and missing her beak, to what seems to be the entrance to like the back of the Fazbear Pizzaplex, where they have like delivery trucks and whatnot. But the question is, why would she be broken if she's coming after us, since it seems like the only thing capable of causing that kind of damage is Monty, who we know is going to be on our ass in that game. So could Glamrock Chica either be helping us the whole time, or more likely be able to switch back at some point to be on the good side, helping us and spending her final animatronic breath to do it? Only time will tell. I need someone as dedicated as Chica. I'm taking applications, ladies. And 4, Stitch Wraith connection. Could Chica have a connection to the Stitch Wraith that none of us know about? Firstly though, let's go over who is the Stitch Wraith. The Stitch Wraith is a mysterious figure wearing Phineas's black trench coat. It wears a white mask, later revealed to be the head of the Simon doll, and the mask's features are drawn on in thick black marker. It has two eyes, one of which is blackened, it sports a toothy grin with a missing tooth, and something appears to be stuck between its front teeth. It's probably skin. It also appears to have blood around its mouth, but it's actually meant to be pizza sauce, but doubt it is. The rest of its body is an endoskeleton of unknown origin, and in its chest lies Fetch's battery, which glowed red when it killed its creator. It's the antagonist of the Fazbear Frights epilogues, however it seems to have a love of collecting broken animatronic pieces. See where I'm going with this? Could the Stitch Wraith be collecting bits of the Glamrock animatronics? A lot of people seem to believe that the purple arm at the end of the gameplay trailer is the Stitch Wraith's, but what if they're right, and William actually ends up taking over the Stitch Wraith's body, at least in the games? Probably not in the epilogues, but at least in the games. This would be an easy way of introducing the character, if that's the case. Getting close to the end in number 3, just a dream. Could Security Breach, much like FNAF 4, just be a dream? This may seem like a long shot, but look at the Security Breach logo animation from a couple trailers, and more importantly, the last couple of Freddy and Friends cartoons. It starts on its side and then comes up, much like how the FNAF 4 logo in their trailer started on its side and then was raised up, as if someone had just gotten out of bed. Doesn't that seem fairly specific to you? And the inclusion of a teaser with Glamrock Chica missing her beak, like Scott teased during a live stream that Matt Pat, among others, were having after the release of FNAF 4. During this live stream, he asked, in the FNAF 4 minigame, why would the tiny toy Chica be missing her beak? Which made them think back to FNAF 2 and how Chica lost her beak when on the attack. So, with that in mind, why would Glamrock Chica be missing her beak again? Sure, it looks like it was ripped off or destroyed, but why? And why seemingly only, or at least focusing on that beak? It's an interesting theory that links back to one of the most controversial theories in all of FNAF, which, according to a poll on the last gaming premiere, four of the top 10 FNAF craziest scary fan theories, a majority of you believe to be true. Interesting. But I mean, to be fair, the Security Breach logo comes from the opposite direction that the FNAF 4 logo did, so maybe that's just indicating that this is in the real world because it's the opposite of a dream. And ultimately, into number 2, good cop, bad cop. There seems to be two separate versions of Toy Chica. One with the guitar and pink sort of bodysuit, I guess it would be, that we see in the gameplay trailers for the main Security Breach game, and the other that we see in Fury's Rage, the side-scrolling beat-em-up that Scott released as an apology to the FNAF fans for the game being delayed, since that version seems to be wearing a skirt, jacket, and green high-heel boots. It's actually green, not pink like my script says. Some think that these are in fact two different versions of the characters, since Roxanne, Foxy, and Monty in that game all seem to have different styles as their main counterparts as well. But why? Perhaps because one group of these animatronics is going to help the player, and the other are the ones that are attacking. Since if you look at the gameplay trailers, those are the only versions we see attacking us, whereas the Fury's Rage versions are fighting off various other animatronics, including alternate versions of Springtrap, who we know is William Afton. So they would worship him if they were actually controlled by him, right? Finally, in at number one, Broken. The ultimate question, however, is ultimately why is Chica's brain bashed in that final security breach teaser image? It's unknown. We seem to be outside the Pizzaplex in the back, which seems to be close to some form of sewer area from what I can see, but Glamrock Chica is absolutely destroyed, especially in the face. The beak is gone, nowhere to be seen, and she even has an arm ripped off. The parallels to Toy Chica from FNAF 2 are being more focused on, especially with this image, yet we still don't know why. As I'm sure you can tell, multiple of these theories mention this image or her missing beak. However, the threads are loose. We don't know why these animatronics are broken. We don't know if they're related or if it's just a red herring. We know nothing about what's going on truly in Security Breach, and I think that's one of the scariest things of all. The sheer mystery behind this game and the horrific implications as such. I'll be surprised if I'm able to sleep tonight. Okay, honestly, I don't think that's the case. I know I'll be fine, but like, it's certainly interesting. I guess we'll have to wait until December to really see. And yes, I think that it's getting released in December in time for like present buying season, because like that makes sense business-wise. I'm thinking, okay, I don't know why, I'm thinking December 17th. Saying it here now, before episode 3 of Freddy and Friends has come out. Just saying. I'm recording this beforehand, December 17th. 2021.
Number 10, the Roxy Connection. Because everyone loves the animatronics in FNAF so much, it should come as no surprise that people even ship them together sometimes. What is shipping? Well, for those who don't know, shipping characters means that you are imagining what it would be like if they dated or were in a relationship. Relationship being the key word from where the term ship comes from. Some fans who ship Foxy and Bonnie together as a couple have even suggested that Roxy is their animatronic daughter. Of course, Foxy and Bonnie are both often referred to as being male animatronics, but they are also, well, animatronics, which means that you could combine pretty much any two animatronics together, regardless of their gender identity or lack thereof, and create something new if you so wish. Perhaps Roxy was more literally even made from parts which came from both Bonnie and Foxy, which is how I'd imagine creating an animatronics offspring would work in FNAF, although that does imply that Foxy and Bonnie may have even had to die for Roxy to live. Pretty dark. Number 9, Montgomery Gator is the new Bonnie. When it comes to who is who in terms of character replacements, this one might seem a little on the nose, but it's still important to note. Montgomery is obviously meant to be the new Bonnie in the games. This isn't just because Roxanne matches up more neatly with taking over Foxy's place, which a lot of people have referred to due to their similar appearance. It's also because of Montgomery versus Bonnie's place in the band as lead guitarist. It seems as though Montgomery is filling in that position in the band, but also in the games in general. And friends, before I move on to this next spot, if you are loving this list and you want some more Security Breach theories, perhaps regarding specific characters, be sure to let us know by giving this video a thumbs up. Number 8, Montgomery is the old Bonnie. We're being led to believe that Security Breach takes place during present day, 2021 or 2020. But what if that just isn't true? What if Security Breach actually takes place during a different time period? The 80s style of the game cannot be ignored. But the question is this some future trend 80s style where retro is made new again? Or does part of, or potentially all of the game, actually take place during the 80s and we've been led astray by the clues that we've gotten so far? Is this some kind of weird misdirect? And if it does take place in the 80s, is it possible that Montgomery was only a temporary replacement for Bonnie, who later rejoined the group afterwards? Perhaps because something bad happened either to or with Montgomery that got him removed from the group and dismantled, something that perhaps that game will explore. Number 7, Surprise Bonnie. Another theory is that Bonnie isn't actually left out of the game at all, it's just that they were simply not in the trailer. Instead of Bonnie being a character that we'll never see, they are simply a character who hasn't shown up yet, but will eventually. Instead of Bonnie being a featured character, that might be an Easter egg or some kind of animatronic surprise that is waiting around the corner to meet us. Anyone see that bowling alley? That could be all the Bonnie we get, honestly. Although it is important to note, just because we haven't seen neither tail nor ears of Bonnie as an animatronic, doesn't mean they aren't just lurking somewhere in the game behind the scenes. Perhaps they aren't in the main band, but instead are relegated to their own super secret attraction, or perhaps they're just chilling at the bowling alley, and we just haven't seen them yet. Number 6, time traveling Bonnie. What if Bonnie is in the game, but giving away just how they showed up would ruin the story for the fans? I've long been wondering if the entirety of Security Breach actually does take place in the present day. After all, we do see a ball pit in the trailer, and fans who have also read the Fazbear Frights books know that the main mention of a ball pit in that series involved time travel. It was a time traveling ball pit. Is it possible that this ball pit could also allow us to time travel? But instead of going to the dingy and grimy Jeff's Pizza, it takes us back in time to another Freddy's location, perhaps even the same location we are in the present, but as it was originally back in the 80s. Is it possible that through time traveling to the past, we could see Bonnie featured in the game, perhaps even a newer version of Bonnie than we're used to seeing, although a newer version to us, but still a version from the past. Does that make sense? We could even still see Bonnie glam-rocked out for all we know. Number 5, Glamrock Bonnie. There are theories that Glamrock Bonnie does exist, but simply has been cut out of the trailer. Why? Well, we don't really know. But perhaps it's because showing Glamrock Bonnie would give too much away in terms of the gameplay or the story. It's possible that Glamrock Bonnie is either directly operating as our ally, or perhaps is tucked away in an area of the game that to show us would basically ruin the whole thing. Glamrock Bonnie could exist though, and perhaps could even have been temporarily taken out of service, which might even be why Montgomery Gator is there to begin with. With human bands, there are times when you might see a band with rotating bandmates as some get pulled into other projects. In this case, it could be because Bonnie is just glitching out, so maybe Bonnie's out for now, but we'll be back? Number 4, Vanny is the new Bonnie. What if Bonnie is actually being replaced by another non-animatronic? Oh, Vanny. MatPat has theorized in the past that Security Breach will be a sort of passing of the torch to a new cast of characters, introducing both new humans and animatronics who could be allies or enemies, or even protagonists. If this is true, then it seems likely that Vanny could be the new Bonnie. After all, both are rabbits and both are antagonists. This would mean, however, sadly, no more Bonnie for us, as that role is already filled. Sad. Unless, of course, something even more sinister is going on when it comes to who might be taking over the role of everyone's favorite animatronic bunny bandmate. Number 3, Bonnie becomes Glitch Trap. We've all focused on the fact that Glitch Trap is looking for a human host, just based on what seems to be implied with him needing or wanting Gregory for some yet unknown purpose. A lot of people assume that Glitch Trap will try to possess Gregory and use him as a host, but does this really make sense? After all, if you're going to take over anyone as an adult, would you really choose to become a child? I mean, being a child was cool and all, but children aren't really able to do as much as adults are because they don't have permission from either their parents or the government. There would be a lot that you couldn't do simply because you just weren't old enough yet, or even because you might not physically be capable of that yet. So why would Glitch Trap want Gregory for this purpose? It's more likely to me that Bonnie is actually the intended host, and Glitch Trap plans or perhaps has already moved into an animatronic and taken hold of it. The fact that Bonnie isn't seen in the trailer could mean that Bonnie is the one who will show up as the new main antagonist, fully possessed by Glitch Trap. And we'll get a big reveal of this, which is why Bonnie doesn't show up, so as not to ruin that big reveal. Number 2, Nightmare Bonnie? What if the hand at the end is actually Bonnie, or at least a version of Bonnie? Some have theorized that this could be William returning as either an Endo version of Bonnie, or perhaps as Nightmare Bonnie, even more frightening. This would also make sense if this was the direction the game and story decided to go in, considering that before he retired, Scott Cawthon was working on Security Breach. Scott has always said the animatronic that scares him the most is Bonnie, so it would make sense that Bonnie would end up as one of the most scary characters that we have in this game, William Afton. Number 1, Bunnies Are Bad. One theory suggests that Bonnie might not appear at all in this game because Fazbear Entertainment's Freddy Fazbear's Mega Pizzaplex is actually part of a soft reboot of the entire franchise. So, Why wasn't Bonnie invited to this party? Because Bonnie is a bunny. And considering that Springtrap was the one behind the murders with William Afton wearing that suit, causing the incidents that had the location shut down in the first place, and basically made them go bankrupt, it would make sense for them to feel that it might just be best to stay away from all the bunny animatronics in general, just to be safe and make everyone feel more at ease. However, that probably still won't end up working out so well for them, as we know that Vanny and Glitchtrap are likely going to be causing a bunch of mayhem still in this game, and they're also both bunny figures. Yikes.